out, bring up the level of competition in the room, and being a versatile guy like he is and can do a lot on the field. So I'm looking forward to Cyrus, you know, excelling for our program.
And you know, you got to Taquan, right, coming back, and yep. I know Tyler did some things, and Danny Smith we've heard a lot about, but you know, it just does seem like there's a lot of guys there.
Yeah, six really good players. Like I said, they're all talented. They're all ready to go. They're all very smart players. I got a room full of smart guys, some tough guys. So, like I said, it's going to be really exciting to see, you know, what this competition looks like. And they know it's going to be a tight competition, and it's going to be week to week, really.
How raring to go is George to try to make up for kind of a lost year last year?
Yeah, I think he's good. You know, unfortunately, the injuries and stuff last year held him back, but he's healthy, good to go, really positive energy, good attitude. So I think he's really excited to get rolling.
You know, in terms of you saying, oh, it's open competition and all that, I mean, how are guys, you know, believing that or going on that in terms of guys that are maybe older, or everyone kind of looks at, okay, you know, George and Cyrus would assume to get most of the carries, but how do you see those younger guys fitting
in? I hope they take it seriously, because the best guys are going to play. Like I said, it's a fresh year. Yeah, George Helani had a great freshman year. He wasn't really around much last year due to his injury. So he is a guy that has established himself, but that doesn't mean you're a lock and doesn't mean you're in there. So, you know, I hope those guys believe me when they say that, and they understand, like, Coach Plow is going to want four running backs to go on the road, and we're going to use all four running backs. So I hope those guys are hungry to understand there's an opportunity. Even if you're not the number one guy, there's an opportunity to be two, three, or four, and I'm making the bus, and I'm going to have an impact on this team.
How, in terms of a Tim Plow offense and how the running backs are used, we've heard a lot about out of the backfield and stuff, but how from what you've seen, I mean, what's it going to be like to be a running back in this offense?
Yeah, you're going to be utilized as a weapon. You know, and they're going to get a lot of touches. That's in the pass game and the run game. So those guys are going to be very active. Once again, that's why we need four to go on the road with us. So they're going to be a very busy running back crew this year. And with Coach Plow's offense, they can expect them to get some passes and run the ball a whole lot.
What have we seen from the O-line? Obviously, four starters coming back, two preseason all-league guys. I mean, I know that's kind of the most criticized position on the field from fans, you know, no matter what happens, because the easiest one to make it look like they screwed up. But how do you see four returning starters and the continuity of that group, and if that group should be improved this year?
Yeah, that group will be well improved this year. You know, Stets, John Ajuku, all these guys, man, Garrett Curran, there's some leadership in that room. Taquani, there's a bunch of guys that are really taking ownership of that group. And you know, it all starts up front. So they know that, and they'll be improved. Coach Keene's come in here and done a great job. I think those guys are believing in him, believing in what we're doing offensively. And that's where it starts, right? The belief in what we're doing, and then the confidence and the mentality to go get after it.
I know in the spring game, the offense was pretty watered down, obviously, for, you know, just always is in the spring and don't want to show anything. And you had some guys out and stuff. But how exciting when this offense is going full blast is it going to be for fans?
Oh, it's going to be exciting. Yeah, it's going to be great. Hopefully, you know, Coach Plow talks about half 100. You know, we're going to put some points on the board, and it should be exciting ball to watch. And hopefully we have the ball in our hands a lot and we score a lot of points.
I know you obviously don't want to give too much away, but in terms of we're hearing like not as many substitutions and just, you know, you're going to run the same plays with whoever's out there and stuff and just going a little faster. I mean, how do you describe, you know what the Boise State offense has been. I mean, how different or similar is it going to be to what's been going on around here?
Yeah, there's a lot of similarities. You know, there's a lot of similarities, some movement, some things that we do offensively. It's just maybe a new call, a new terminology to it. And, you know, we'll play with some tempo. I think if you watch Coach Plow's offenses, they play with a little bit of tempo. Like you're saying, there's maybe not as many substitutions. I mean, we're going to sub. We have to have the right personnel in and things like that. But, you know, we're going to push it a little bit. And there's going to be a time to push it, and there's going to be a time to slow it down. So, really, that's going to be week to week. We're not going to necessarily have an identity that we're a fast-paced team like that. I mean, it's going to be week to week. And what we're trying to accomplish might determine what kind of tempo we use.
You were part of some of those teams where you had the big season opener and kind of set the stage for the rest of the season.
Yeah.
To be playing Central Florida and on the Thursday night to start the season on ESPN, I mean, I assume you're not going to have to work too hard to motivate the guys during fall camp.
No, that's Boise State, right? Like you're saying. I mean, those are the games that we prove ourselves. Those are the tough games that we go and travel on the road, and there's always a great crowd. I know UCF, I've heard that they've had a great stadium, great fans, so it's not going to be anything that we haven't done before. Maybe this next group, class of 21, this will be their first game. But it's something that we've done in Boise State for a while, is go attack those first games and really set up the confidence for the rest of the season.